Komoko Pearl Farm is a family-run farm that produces pearls in the nutrient-rich lagoon of Ahe Atoll, 300 miles northeast of Tahiti in French Polynesia. This 75-square-mile lagoon is a vibrant ecosystem that encompasses all types of wildlife. Komoko Pearl Farm follows very strict levels of sustainable pearl farming while using eco-farming techniques. Electricity is supplied to the farm by solar and wind power, while fresh water on the farm comes from collected rainwater. Patrick Humber is the father of the Humber family and is the founder of Komoko Pearl. Patrick claims that he has always had an interest in the sea. His foundational knowledge and passion for the ocean led him to believe that great things could come from the nutrient-rich lagoon of Ahe, and this led to the beginning of Komoko Pearl. In the beginning, the earnings of the farm were made by producing and selling the oysters, not grafting them yet. The profits made at the beginning of the business were used to build the structure of the farm and the lagoon. A year after the business was founded, Josh Humber joined the family business. Josh Humber is Patrick Humbert's son and is currently the manager and owner of Komoko Pearl with the help of his family and wife Celeste. When Josh was 2 years into his marine biology degree, he realized that he could leave school and do hands-on marine biology work on the farm while contributing to his family's business. His desire to produce and research pearl farming took place after becoming friends with an experienced Japanese grafting technician who showed Josh the ropes of the trade. Currently, Josh manages the farm with the help of his wife Celeste, who runs the business side of the farm, selling and making jewelry. Komoko Pearl cultures their pearl from a species of local oyster called Pinctada margaritifera that is naturally abundant in the wild in French Polynesia. In their natural form, this species starts out its life as a free-swimming larvae plankton for the first 3 weeks until their shell becomes too heavy to keep swimming. Once this occurs, the oysters settle and attach by their byssus to a hard substratum such as stones, crevices, and algae. Oysters are intertidal and subtidal for most of their lives and are epiphaunal suspension feeders. These oysters reach sexual maturity after 1 year and are considered protandrous hermaphrodites, which means that they begin their lives as males and become females to reproduce. Komoko cultures high-quality pearls from these oysters and produces various types of jewelry to sell locally or internationally. Celeste and her son Tavai run the store and ship product from their home in Oregon in the United States. Their product types include necklaces, bracelets, earrings, rings, and pendants. All the products showcased on their website are unique, and once the item is sold, it is taken down from their website. Komoko prides themselves on producing high-grade pearls for their pearl-based products. But what exactly makes a pearl high-grade? In the Tahitian grading system, pearls are graded as A through D, with A being the highest quality. The grade is based on size, quality, and shape. A grade pearls are officially 90% perfect with great luster and no more than two imperfections within 10% out of allotted surface. The lower letters represents decreased luster, nacre thickness, color orientation, and other qualities.
Growing and culturing oysters is a complicated art, and it's not as easy as it looks to create high-grade quality pearls. The process begins when collectors are placed in the lagoon and used to catch free-swimming plankton oysters seasonally. The collectors are placed strategically and create a dark, safe place for the spat, or young oysters, to settle and grow. As the oysters grow, they are constantly under threat of predation by triggerfish, sea turtles, and rays. Once oysters are about 2.5 years old, they have reached size where they are ready to be grafted. During the grafting process, a piece of mantle is taken from the donor oyster and transplanted into another oyster. Oysters that have the nicest mantle color are selected to be mantle donors because that is what will determine the color of the pearls. One mantle donor oyster will produce enough transplant tissue to supply up to 30 oysters. A mother of pearl nuclei is then inserted in the oyster which has just received the transplant tissue so that a pearl can be made. The mother-of-pearl nuclei refers to a small piece of shell from a Pinctada margaritifera oyster that has been shaped into a ball and covered with antibiotic coating to help oyster fight infection. After the grafting process, oysters are placed in a basket at strategic locations around the lagoon that offer protection from predation and optimal feeding conditions. Once the pearl is made and ready to be cultured, the fully formed pearls are carefully extracted from the oysters using precision tools. The second graft then takes place, where a new mother of pearl nuclei, approximately the same size as the pearl that was taken out, is placed into the oyster, and the oyster is placed back into the ocean to grow some more. After an oyster produces two or three pearls, healthy oysters are released back into the ocean and sick oysters are removed from the environment. The pearls are then sent to Oregon, where Celeste and other workers create various jewelries.
As you mentioned earlier, Kamoko Pearls is known for their high-grade pearls, but they're also known for their unique qualifications, certifications, and pearl farming techniques. One sustainable technique that was actually pioneered by Kamoka is the material used for their nuclei, in other words, the core or center of the pearl. While many other pearl farms use mussel-based nuclei, Kamoka actually uses mother-of-pearl nuclei, which are obtained through their oysters. Not only is this method more sustainable, but the Tahitian Pearl Farming Board found in independent tests that the nuclei Kamoka uses produce 3 times more A-grade pearls than any other foreign nucleus type. Kamoka Pearls also takes place in creating eco-friendly farming techniques that help the local environment. The following technique was actually invented by Josh himself. Oysters are usually grown close to the surface of the water, where high oxygen and plankton levels are found, making these oysters particularly susceptible to harmful levels of organism growth, which then, in turn, negatively affects the pearl quality. Traditional or larger-scale industrialized companies combat this issue by periodically power-washing their oysters. The biggest repercussion of this method are population explosions of sea anemones and sponges, which release spawn into the water when aggravated or broken, a common side effect of power-washing. Kamoka Pearls does not use power-washing, but instead relies on the natural predation of fish on the microorganisms that grow on the oysters to help keep the oysters clean and allow for the production of high-quality pearls.
What's really interesting is that each organism that grows on the oyster has its own species of fish that likes to eat it, and each one has different adaptations to eat the specific organism on the oyster. So you get this incredible, beautiful array of fish coming and eating the organisms off the oyster. So
these sustainability efforts have not gone unnoticed. In fact, the efforts caught the attention of National Geographic, who came and completed a test that proved that the fish populations in the lagoon had increased since the beginning of the sustainability efforts done by Kamoka Pearl Farm. These techniques also caught the attention of educational institutions, with which Kamoka collaborates with regularly. Dr. Kent E. Carpenter of Old Dominion University and Laurent Cartier of University of Basel are both scientists that periodically collaborate with Kamoka and run experiments that focus on fish populations in the lagoon. But these university collaborations don't stop at professors and master students. Kamoka Pearl has welcomed students from all over the world to come and get work experience on their farm. Since the main language of Tahiti is French, many students from France seek out work at Kamoka, but anyone is welcome. Kamoka also has a strong presence in the community. Many of the employees on the pearl farm are local people, and Kamoka prides themselves on trying to employ as many local people as possible to create local jobs and boost the local economy.
You know, French Polynesian people are extremely suited to pearl farming. Like, you know, it's working on the ocean, it's working hard, it's, you know, working in your environment. Most people are great divers and swimmers.
Kamoka Pearl also tries to give back as much as possible to their community, not only through job opportunities, but also through donations and relief efforts. They participate in monthly donations to the National Resources Defense Council, the NRDC, and additional donations to Waves for Water, an organization dedicated to getting water to affected areas after natural disasters. While also donating half of their sales to relief efforts during the Hurricane Maria period, they're also a member of an organization called 1% for the Planet, in which 1% of all of their profits goes to this organization. Finally, Kamoka's reach surpasses French Polynesia and even their contacts in the US, Switzerland, and France. In June 2014, co-owner Josh Humbert was one of just over a dozen keynote speakers to attend the world's first Sustainable Pearl Forum in Hong Kong. Pearl work and live together in a communal setting located on the lagoon. While their days are spent culturing and taking care of their oysters, their nights are spent watching the sunset over the lagoon while enjoying music. Fish is the main source of food on the island and serves as a staple crop for locals as it is used for livestock. Even though the island of Ahe appears to be wonderful, there are hardships living in such an isolated location, including the constant fight against infection and the need to deal with your own wastewater and garbage facilities. Although living and farming in such a remote place does pose its challenges, Kamoko Pearl is proud to culture pearls from the nutrient-rich lagoon that surrounds them while continuing to respect the environment around them that produces their livelihood. Sustainable farming is about forming a symbiotic relationship between the farmer and the farmed organism. However, the right symbiotic relationship needs to occur. Too many times, this relationship is parasitic, when really we can't hope to deem ourselves sustainable until the relationship is mutualistic or commensal at very least. Kamoko Pearl Farms focuses on creating a mutualistic relationship between them and their oysters, and they believe that a healthy lagoon and healthy environment is closely correlated to having a healthy business. The sustainable family-run farm has developed techniques that have made it the world's leading sustainable pearl farm. They continue to work on even more ways to shrink their environmental footprint and stand as an example of what the future of sustainable aquaculture holds.
The cleaner you keep your environment, the healthier the environment, the healthier your business.
To learn more information about Kamoko Pearl, you can visit their website, Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter page.